who has a production company called Singing Bird Productions that has got a very interesting series that is running at the moment in Sydney. It's a series called Music and Me. And Angela's come in to tell us a bit about the series and about what's coming up next Friday evening at Paddington Uniting Church. Angela, warm welcome to Fine Music 102.5. Great to have you.
Good morning, Peter.
Now, tell us about this amazing series that you're doing, Music and Me.
Thank you. Music and Me is really about connecting some classical music that we all love to a particular guest's life story. And we're choosing guests that are not normally known for a connection to music in their public life. And so we find out some really interesting connections to the music that they select for the concert. And the basis behind it really was finding opportunities for young artists to perform the music that we all love practicing and performing for our audiences. But we wanted to draw in a broader audience to what we're doing. And by having a guest, that adds a really interesting element to exploring the music and the text and, yeah, the stories behind it.
Now, who's the guest next Friday?
So next Friday we have the delightful Maggie Beer with us, and she's coming across especially for our event. So, yeah, it's very exciting that she's agreed to join us.
So she'll be talking about the music that's important in her life, maybe the music that's inspired her cooking.
Well, you never know. Yes.
And how does it work? Because the event is actually compared by somebody else, isn't it?
That's right. Yes. No. So the event itself, or the concert itself, is compared by Emma Ayres from Classic FM, ABC Classic FM.
You can say that here. That's okay.
And, so Emma guides the interview with Maggie and guides the audience through Maggie's music selections. And so they talk about each piece of music and how that relates to her life and the stories that are connected to that, which are usually very, very interesting and a lot of things that we haven't heard about our guest before. And then us as artists will then perform each of those pieces of music.
So how big is the ensemble that will be in Paddington Uniting Church next week?
Okay, for next Friday we have five singers and a clarinetist and an accompanist.
And does Emma play as well? Because she's, of course, a viola player.
She does play, yes, but not in the concert, no. She sticks to interviewing.
Oh, okay, yeah. Right. Well, that'll be great.
So far.
And so you know quite a long time in advance what the work is going to be, or the works are going to be from your guest.
Yes, we do. Yeah, we ask them to select that a couple of months in advance, so then I can organise the ensemble of artists that perform for the concert.
Have you ever had any really curly requests?
There have been one or two requests that we've vetoed, and that's really just because of the ensemble of artists that we have at the time, and we are stretching ourselves across a number of genres. Nothing curly, but just, you know, we try and accommodate as best as we can. So we've ventured into jazz and some cabaret and even country. And, you know, a whole lot of genres besides classical music and opera.
Now, you're a singer, so you move across all those genres as well. You can do classical, jazz, country.
Yeah, I guess that's one of the benefits of the background that I've had, is that, yes, I have done quite a bit of music theatre, but, you know, sung in some different groups that, yes, has given me a background in most of those genres, actually. So, yeah, it's quite a nice, unique opportunity for me, too, to be coming across all of those genres and slipping in and out of all of those, along with some other really fabulous artists.
And keep you on your toes, I would guess.
It does, it does. But it's really, yeah, it's really an exciting adventure so far, yes.
Now, Maggie Beer is coming up, is your next guest, but who else have you had? You've had some interesting people in this series.
Yes, and it's been really encouraging, the guests that have agreed to come on board. And we started with Michael Kirby, who is actually now our company's patron. He loves what we're doing and is very supportive. And we then moved into Christina Keneally, who had not long come out of being the Premier, and then Julie McCrossan later in the year. And a couple of months ago, we had Thomas Keneally. So, yeah, it's been a really fabulous program so far.
So you're looking for people who are in the public eye but whose musical tastes may not be at the forefront. For example, with Christina Keneally, we might
exactly.
not have known the extent of her musical interests.
Yeah, that's exactly right, yes. And that's what makes it so interesting and a different kind of angle for exploring the guest and also the music too.
And is Emma Ayres your compere for all of these productions?
She has been for all of them except for Michael Kirby, just simply because she wasn't able to make it at the time. She would have loved to have interviewed him. But, yeah, she has been for all of our interviews so far, which has been really fabulous.
It sounds terrific. It sounds like a really good idea, a very interactive evening.
Very much so. And very, very intimate in the setting and the way that it's set up, and the stories that she brings out of them are really sometimes quite extraordinary and very, very meaningful.
Yeah, I'm sure. Mm. Now, tell us about it's next Friday, the 14th of September.
That's right.
What's the timing?
Okay, so the doors open at 7:30, but the concert starts at 8 p.m., okay? And you can book tickets. We do strongly recommend that everybody books online because we are filling up fairly quickly now. So it's www.trybooking.com/BPNM. That's /BPNM. Okay.
And what do tickets cost? What's the price of tickets?
If you book them online for adults, it's $28. For students, it's $20. If you have a group of 6, 8 or 10, it's $25. If you come at the door, and there will be limited door sales, so we do encourage you to book online, door sales is $30 for adults and $20 for students.
Terrific. Okay, I'll just repeat those details a little later. Now, one of the works that's featuring next week is the Flower Duet from Delibes. Is that a work that's commonly chosen by your guests? Is it a favourite piece?
I know. Surprisingly, it hasn't yet, but I'm expecting it to come up again at some stage because it is such a beautiful fusion of soprano voices. It's just a gorgeous piece.
Now, you brought a copy of that performance in. We'll play that in a moment. Just tell us about the performance that we're going to hear.
Oh, so the performance is none other than Dame Joan Sutherland, and it's recorded quite some time ago in the 1960s from her album of Sutherland, Bonnie and Friends. So it's a retro recording, but it's still very beautiful. Yeah.
Great. Okay, Angela Lewis, thank you very much for coming into the studio for this morning. Good luck with this series, Music and Me. The event featuring Maggie Beer next Friday evening at Paddington United Church sounds as though it's going to be a great success. We wish you continued success with the series and hope you'll do come back and tell us more about the series as it progresses.
Thank you so much, Peter.
Joan Sutherland with Jane Berbe, and the National Orchestra of the Opera of Monte Carlo, conducted by Richard Bonney, in that performance of The Flower Duet by Lakmé, famous, well-known, and very beautiful piece. And that will feature in the concert to be presented next Friday evening, the 14th of September, at Paddington Uniting Church. Music and Me, featuring Maggie Beer with Angela Lewis and friends, who will be performing music selected by Maggie Beer, who will be interviewed by ABC Classic FM's Emma Ayres. And as Angela was saying, to book tickets, you can go online at trybooking.com/BPNM, and tickets are $28 and $20 online. And Angela, as Angela was saying, it's advisable to book and preferable to book online, so fire up the computer.